Hey guys, Rob coming at you from Karma Comma Chameleon. Today we're looking at another Ask Reddit thread. Let's see this one. It is Long Haul Truckers. What's the creepiest or most paranormal thing you've seen on the road at night? All right, I'm kind of scared, but let's jump into this one right now. I was driving near Las Vegas at around 3 a.m. I had been following a few black SUVs along the highway for a good hour or so. They had Nevada plates that were single-digit numbers in order, 1, 2, 3. Suddenly, they all pulled off the highway down a dirt path. There was no mile marker or cactus that would indicate a path there. It was just dirt. After pulling off the road, they all turned their lights off. I didn't stick around. It was creepy. They were absolutely going out to a base or testing site. There are a bunch around Vegas. My great uncle was a long haul trucker, and he swears that one time he was driving down the road to see two guys pull a rolled up carpet out of the trunk of their car and throw it in the river. Whether that's true or not, I don't know, but it's still creepy nonetheless. I am a log truck driver in the Pacific Northwest. We go up into the woods on the logging roads and haul logs back from the loggers to sawmills. We start work very early in the morning, 2 to 5 a.m., so it's nighttime obviously. One of my coworkers pulled away from the job and started down the logging road. After a couple miles, after the load had settled a bit, he decided to pull over and throw his remaining wrappers around the load. As he is tying down his load, he looks back and saw a mountain lion watching him from 10 feet off the end of his trailer. He slowly backed up to his driver door and got in. By the time he looked in his mirror, the lion had disappeared. Not paranormal, but it's damn sure creepy. We see lions and bears fairly often out there, but to be that close and out of the truck, we face different obstacles up in the woods than highway drivers. My dad has several stories from hauling logs in Idaho and driving trucks through Utah and Nevada. My favorite is from actually just in his pickup going through Utah. He said there was a light keeping pace with him out in the desert on a moonless night. It kept pace for a minute before it disappeared and his truck turned off. He stopped and turned it on and pulled off at the next diner. The folks in the diner called it a common occurrence. The creepiest is when he was hauling logs in Idaho and was coming down from near Coeur d'Alene area during a snowy winter night. He was putting on chains before heading down steep grade and said all of the hair stood up on his body. It felt like there was something watching him. Halfway down the switchbacks, he saw a large figure standing on a 20-foot tall embankment. As he got closer, it jumped down and the shoulders were as tall as the cab. In a single bound, it leaped down and then leaped over to the other side of the embankment. At the time he thought it was a Sasquatch, now he says it was probably a demon trying to make him crash. He didn't stop to remove the chains until he was well away from the mountain. I drove by a marsh every night when I was going home from work. One night I saw a car pulled over with hazards on. Dude was head to toe covered in blood. No crash, no injury, just covered in blood. Maybe he just had one hell of a bloody nose. Creepiest, driving I-30 through Texas and Arkansas, I would see what looked like animals and faces popping out of the bushes, but longer than a glance proved nothing was there. They had just paved the highway and there was hardly any traffic. I was dead tired, it was super dark. Highway hypnosis, I suppose. Paranormal. When I went to local driving, my route ran near an Air Reserve base in Indiana, so you'd see planes and helicopters pretty often. One night, about 2 a.m., I was headed to pick up another load when I saw a bright green light in the corner of my windshield. It was too low to be an aircraft. It moved pretty slowly, then darted, and I lost sight of it behind some trees I drove by. Typical, I saw a UFO stuff, but I still think it was just a helicopter or a jet that I saw at the perfect angle that turned after a takeoff. The jet pilots have broken the sound barrier over town a couple times in the past, sonic boom, so a jet flying abnormally isn't necessarily out of the realm of possibility. I was 23, my newly married husband and I decided driving team would be a fun adventure after college rather than jumping into the 9-to-5. I was down in Arizona on a long stretch of nothing about 4 a.m. when a guy pulled up next to me waving his CB. I never left mine on, listening to those guys' BS was irritating. I turned on my CB and he told me I had a blown tire. I thanked him, figuring I would stop at the next truck stop. He kept harassing me to pull over and check my tire for a good 40 miles. I finally got to a next town and pilot truck stop, got out and checked my truck, no blown tires anywhere. No clue what that guy would have done to me, but I'm so glad I trusted my gut and didn't stop. Not paranormal, but I have plenty of stories as a young woman on the road. I'm a truck driver in the UK, was driving through rural Scotland one night going down a country lane. All of a sudden I start to see flashing lights coming through the trees. lights of all colors flashing through the trees and causing some really freaky looking shadows on the road. I'm not a believer of aliens or anything, but my first thought was UFOs. Safe to say, I put my foot down and got out of there. Found out the next day it was a rave happening in a field, but at the time it didn't half scare me. I was coming back home from a trip in Michigan and I saw these people wearing cult-like robes. One in town, one on a highway, and one in a park, all staring at me. Did you approach the dog park? You're not supposed to do that. Maybe a bit off the mark, but it still scared the crap out of me. I was headed west on I-76 here in Denver, just cruising along at about 70 miles per hour. Out of nowhere, I saw a massive, almost solid cloud of what looked to be dirt coming at me. I'd say it was at least 20 feet wide and 10 feet tall. I scanned ahead of me but couldn't see any vehicle it could have come from. With nowhere to go, I slowed down and took the hit, hoping there wasn't anything big enough in there to come through the windshield or jack up my truck. I'm an owner-operator. It was pretty loud as I smashed through it. The instant it hit, I knew it wasn't dirt though. I immediately hit the washers because I couldn't see a damn thing through all the carnage. My windshield was painted with guts. Turns out it was bees, freaking huge bees that sounded like rocks when they hit. I can't even imagine seeing that swarm if I was walking. They would kill the crap out of anything in their path. Myself and two friends had to drive from Laredo, Texas to Baton Rouge, LA one night in my Ford van. It was about 2 a.m. There's a particularly long and dark section of highway just outside Laredo, no buildings, towns, or lights for about 50 miles. I was in the right lane coming up on a truck and pulled out into the left passing lane. As I was slowly overtaking this long truck, my peripheral vision caught a sudden movement of this big truck towards the right shoulder. I saw the truck was swerving to avoid hitting a person, dressed all in white, white face, whose arms were folded across the chest and eyes were closed as they were walking across the highway. I swerved to the left and barely missed this ghostly looking person with my passenger mirror. Can still remember seeing that the eyes were closed. That's how close we came to hitting this person. Not a long haul trucker, but thought this would fit here, also on a mobile, so sorry for format. My mom, sister, and I were on our way to a baseball game of mine during my junior year of high school. This was in northern New York, so spring got a little chilly at times. The main road we took stretched about 35 miles and was nothing but cornfields and tree lines. We hit a stretch of the road that was super foggy for no reason, so my mom slowed down to a proper speed. We finally reached the end of the fog and we all looked to the left to see where we were. About 50 yards from the road was a man and a woman in what appeared to be wedding clothing from at least 100 years ago. Man was wearing a big top hat, and the woman was wearing a very old-looking white dress, holding hands with their backs to us walking toward the wood line. We drove past and I just remember the silence in the car, until my mom said, "What the flip was that?" Till this day, whenever we are all together and one of us tells the story, we all get goosebumps. My grandfather was in the Air Force and one night he was driving, back to his base maybe, I can't quite remember, and he saw a woman standing on the side of the road in a long white dress at about 2 a.m. He circled back to ask if she needed help and she was nowhere to be seen. He searched for her for about an hour before giving up and deciding to leave it alone. When he decided to go on his way, he had a strong feeling that he needed to switch lanes. He was on the road alone in the middle of the night, so he had no idea why. And just ahead on the road, there was a broken down truck with no hazards on that he would have hit, and probably been killed by if he'd stayed in the lane that he'd been in. To this day, he's convinced the woman was trying to warn him like an omen or something. A few years ago, some animal rights activists managed to release thousands of mink from a farm next to a large road at night. The road was more blood than tarmac for miles. Remains everywhere, and don't even get me started on the smell. I'm a stand-up comic. I often refer to my profession as being a trucker with jokes. Near the north end of mainland Michigan, I saw a car stopped on the side of the highway. We hadn't seen a car for a while. It was 2 a.m. I commented to my buddy, poor bastard. But as we passed the car, the lights came on and it got back on the road. Odd timing. And then it was gaining on us. I told my friend to speed. He did. He sped more and the car kept closing in. We were doing 120 and this guy was catching up to us. We saw an exit with a hotel, so we took it and drove right in front of the building, where it was well lit and we could see the front desk clerk. The car got off that exit too. It drove into the hotel parking lot, then turned around, and got back on the highway. I'll never know what that guy wanted from us. I'm fine with that remaining a mystery. My dad is a trucker, and about 13 to 15 years ago, while resting at the side of the road, he woke up in the morning seeing that his entire trailer was robbed empty. My dad's a heavy sleeper, but his cargo could not have been stolen without at least a forklift, and everyone would have woken up by a forklift unloading a trailer. My dad suspects the robbers used a pump to get some kind of chloroform into his cabin to make sure he couldn't wake up. Wow, some of those stories were kind of scary and some of them were just odd. I couldn't imagine some of the things these people ran into on the road. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. This is Rob from Karma Comet Chameleon. Send subscribe, like, and share the videos to your friends, and we'll see you in the next video.